Hi guys, and welcome back to SITENG. In today's video, I'm going to tell you about the global grid and the local grid, the differences, and I'm going to describe you what it's all about and why we say global grid and how to use the local grid as well. I'm going to start from the British national grid here, I'm going to explain you what it's all about with all these squares. And then later, guys, I'm going to jump into the CAD drawing, and I'm going to create a local grid here, and I'm going to explain you how to do it step by step. And before we go, guys, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel, leave the thumbs up if you like it, leave the comments if you got any questions, and don't forget to follow my LinkedIn page as well. So let's go! So guys, I know everyone asking about the local grid, oh local, global. So I decided I'm gonna do actually probably two videos about this, as I want you actually to know what we mean by saying global grid and local grid. So first of all, I'm gonna start from the global grid, and I'm gonna try to explain it the most engineering way in terms of like site engineering and civil engineering, as this is obviously a geodesy and all surveying, and all these guys probably got more knowledge about it, and they as well need more knowledge about it. But for us engineers who wants to work in construction, we need actually the little knowledge, but to get the understanding of what's going on, and not to be just blind and trying marking and all the stuff. So I decided I'm going to start from the global grid. And in this case, guys, it's not really the global grid. What we're using here, it's a British national grid, and you can have a look. I opened actually Wikipedia. I leave the links here so you can read through it anyway. I'm not going to be spending too much time on it, as I said, you can read through it. But what I want to show you, I want to focus a little bit about this map here and the system use for the coordinates. But before I say a little bit more about it, I just show you the geoid, which is the model of the Earth. It's based on the ellipsoid. So based on that shape, obviously all the systems, all the grid systems are created. So this is another one. You can just have a look on the Wikipedia and have a look yourself, read about it a little bit, how the model was created, and why this is important to know there is something like this. And based on this shape, everything is calculated later. And also I want to show you this. This is actually the 1984 geoid models. So this is World Geodetic System, is WGS 84. You probably seen it. I think it's even in the EDM. You can have a look at this. It's probably show this base your coordinates. So this is all obviously the Cartesian coordinate system, but then applied to this model, and then that's what we're actually using on site for the setting out. So I'm going to go back to that nice map here and that division here, and I'm going to explain you a little bit more about it. But before I jump to this, I want to open the CAD and I tell you a little bit what we're doing here as engineers, as we are making our life always easy and easy. And the way we're doing this is always approximation, interpolation, and making errors so small that we can actually omit it. So that's exactly what's happening here as well in terms of setting out. I quickly jump here on AutoCAD, guys, and I'm going to show you something. If I create an ellipsoid, let's say, guys, here, let's say it doesn't really matter how it's going to be looking. Obviously, let's say not going to be looking more like Earth. I think this can show you the easiest way, so you're gonna understand how why we're working, and that's what I said about the approximation, all the interpolation, and all the stuff to make easy for us engineers. As remember, guys, engineers want to make life easy for themselves. So if I'm gonna take the line, let's say, and I'm gonna make it tangent to this, you can see that all this, let's say even the arc, wherever, you can see the shape of the ellipsoid. But once I'm gonna start zooming in, guys, and getting closer and closer and closer, obviously there is a one point, tangent point, but as you can see now, the closer I'm getting to this, the more flat it is. And if you zoom it enough, our line gonna be actually covering that part of the ellipsoid of that arc. So you can see, guys, the closer we are getting to this, the more flat the surface it is. And the same story is with the Earth, and the same story goes for the coordinate system. As obviously, guys, while we're working on site, we're using the coordinates. For us, that area, that few hundred meters we work in, is actually flat, and we treat it as flat. When we add in the meters and centimeters, whatever, we're not thinking about the curve of the Earth and all that stuff. So the closer you are, you're actually the closer to the flat surface. I'm going to go back to that map here, and you can see these squares, let's say. In this case, I think that's the best one. Each of these squares, guy, is 100 kilometers. And as you can see here, let's say that's actually showing this is a good case in London here. It says Royal Observatory, Greenwich. So that's again what I said. It's not a global. It's not a global grid. This is the British grid, and we call it global. Obviously, wherever you're going to be on site, someone says, "Oh, in global or in local." But the one thing you need to remember, guys, once I'm talking about this, if you're using the robotic EDM, if you're using TS15 or TS16 on Topcon robotic, where you can actually upload the drawings, you're going to be working in our global system. This is no point to creating a local grid for your job. But anyway, I'm going to tell you about the local grid as well. So we're going back here. Each of these square is 100 kilometers. And some of you guys may be working in London here. You know, there was you had probably Easting 52 something and Northing 18. On the last job, I hit 19. So the reason for it is, look, 100 kilometers. So let's say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So that's the reason for it's 552, whatever. So this is 500 kilometers. So that's the reason why you're working in global grid. You got 500 kilometers. So we got all these digits, then dot, and we got the millimeters. Obviously, we're working to the millimeters. We want to get it exactly as possible once we set it out on site. But all these digits, all these meters are exactly this. So 500 kilometers is going to be your 500,000 meters. And that's why the numbers are so big. And once you're going to get it local, you're going to make it probably smaller. So we're going to be easier to type in, especially when using the TS06. And the same goes for Northing, obviously. So we got 100 here, 200 here. So we got 18 here with Summer Hill, let's say, in terms of London. And actually, just showing the Greenwich Observatory here. And if you want to know about what these letters mean, so you can actually go to Wikipedia. We don't really care about this as we're working with a digit. So obviously, as you can see here, the TQ, that stands for this particular square, which is then divided to even more square. And this square is also divided to the more squares, guys. So that's exactly what I showed you on that cut drawing, that curve. The smaller it gets, the more flat it is, and then we can work in the area treating it as a flat surface. I really recommend you to go through this links, open this, read through it, and if you got any questions, obviously, guys, leave the comments and I'm gonna explain a little bit more if you need it. But I think from our engineering point of view, that's all you need to know, guys, that there is some geoid model created, and actually our global grid, guys, that's the British geoid system here, and that's the coordinates we're using working here in UK. And obviously, if you're going to be working somewhere else in other countries, I don't know, maybe Abu Dhabi or wherever you're going to be working, you're gonna have a different system. So don't be surprised if you see completely different numbers where you're going to be putting Easting and Northing. So guys, I'm going to try to tell you a little bit about the local grid as well. So let's say we're working in one of these squares here, and once we get closer and closer and closer and closer, obviously somewhere there that our building going to be somewhere there in that square. And I'm going to open drawing now quickly and tell you a little bit about it. So guys, I got a drawing here now. It's one of the blocks on which I cover in my side videos, if you remember. But this is the higher level here. And let's say we want to create a local grid. Obviously, guys, while we're using the robotic total station, like TS16, TS15, Topcon, or whatever, we're going to be uploading information, drawings to our controller or to our tablet, and then we're going to be doing setting out. So there is no reason for creating a local grid and working with it. But when we're working with the so-called two-man stations, like TS06 typically, the very good thing will be, and that might be actually the very first thing we're going to be doing on-site with the old grid system, we're going to create a local grid. I'm going to use this drawing here, and my starting point for my grid is going to be this one, the crossing of grid lines C1 and CN, and that's going to be my corner of my building, actually. So guys, as I said, this is in global, just going to show you quickly here, ID. So this grid line was 51 something and 18 something, which coming back to our squares from where we got these numbers. So this is global grid, guys. And this point is actually very important, as that's going to be my point. I'm going to be referencing my local grid to, and based on this, I'm going to change everything, and obviously our control points as well. So when we're going to do the resection, we're going to be actually setting our EDM in the local system. But this I'm going to keep to the next video, guys, when I'm going to tell a little bit more about it. I'm going to show you the spreadsheet you can use, and also I'm going to do maybe another drawing just to clarify everything. So guys, for this, for changing this into global, guys, I'm going to use the UCS command here, and so that's the UCS. And to make it square to the building, our new grid, make it parallel, I just press here, and I'm going to go with the grid line. So I'm going to find the intersection here to be sure there's not going to be any error. So that's the intersection here of these grid lines and intersection of these grid lines here. And for now, guys, this point here is my new 0,0 point, but I'm going to move it in a minute anyway. So you can have a look here. This is 0,0 now. And this grid line here, if I press the ID, that grid line going to be 0,0 and 8,4,3,5. So what I want to do, guys, now, obviously I don't want my grid line to start at 0,0. I'm going to use, let's say, 4,000 for Easting and 2,000 for Northing. So I'm going to take all this drawing now, and I'm going to just move it to the point here. This drawing is in millimeters, guys, so obviously I have to use it. I'll take this point from here, and I'm going to use 4,000, that is millimeters, and 2,000, that's going to be our Northing. And I'm going to press Enter, double click the roll. So I'm going to get to here now. We're going to double check now if this is correct now, if I move it correctly. ID 4,000, 2,000. So that's exactly what I wanted. And that should be 2008. Let's have a look if this is the case. So that's Easting 4,000 and Northing 2008, 435. So yeah, this is in millimeters, guys. So in the next video, I'm going to show you that spreadsheet. I'm going to tell you a little bit more about the local grid, and I'm going to do next drawing in meters. So they're going to be all clear. So guys, as I said, this is my 4,000. So I can actually call it, you're going to see this on some jobs. People typically, they got the drawings with the grid lines marked. So that's our 4,000 and 0,0 millimeters. And that's the Easting. And I'm going to put the number here on the Northing, which is our 2,000 in this case, guys. And obviously, guys, please wait for the next video where I'm going to explain a little bit more about it. And if you got any questions, just leave them here so I can maybe even answer while I'm going to be doing that video. But that's how it works, guys. And this is 4,000 here, 2,000. And if you look, if you're going to be looking for the grid line C2, let's say, that's going to be our 4,000 plus 8,4,3,5. This is millimeters, guys. So our grid line C2 going to be 4,008 meters, 0.435 millimeters. And from this number, obviously, wherever you're going to be setting here, so this way you're going to be adding, and this way you're going to be distracting, guys. But once you got a cut drawing set like this, obviously you can use ID point and whatever ID you're going to have here, that's going to be in your local grid, and you can just type it in to your instrument, or you can just copy from the cut drawing and upload it into your TSO6. And once you got it here, press, that's going to be 4,009,335 and 2,033.652 millimeters. That's this corner in the new local grid which we just set. So guys, I think that's the easiest way to create your local grid. And obviously later you can align your new drawings and all the stuff I'm going to show you in the next video. I don't want to make it video too long. I just want to make sure you understand the whole big picture, how it's all created, how the grid is created, how then becoming the smaller fragments make it more flat for us. So we actually work in omitting that curve, as the error is so small, it's obviously near to zero. So it's, for us, is zero, and we are working in the flat. And then getting closer, creating for our block, we can create a local grid and then work with it. So guys, I think that will be all into this video. I think I covered a global, so-called global grid for us, our British grid here for the UK. And then the local grid, I think that shows you how it works, guys, how you can change it yourself. Obviously, you can move it to wherever point you want. And then in the next video, guys, I'm going to show you the transformation, so we can actually going to be using our control station and all the points, so we can set in that local grid, and then using this drawing, which is changed now to the local, we're going to be doing our setting out. So thank you again for watching, guys. If you like it, guys, don't forget to leave the thumbs up, leave some comments, guys, below. This is helping to grow this channel and making more people watching this and get more knowledge about these things. And please don't forget to subscribe to this channel. And thank you again for watching, guys, and see you next time.